Right, another video, this time the S-Type lock that doesn't want to unlock. So let's see what I can find. On the underside here we have a Phillips screw. So you undo that screw. Yeah, seems to be a self-tapper. Okay, I'm surprised at that. I would have thought Jaguar would have put a threaded one in there. All right. And pull off the bracket. Put that there, that ain't going nowhere. Okay, so that just comes down to a little lever mechanism. Now, I have choices here because is it not being actuated here somewhere, which I would have to take this cover off to find out, or is it having a problem here? Well, we don't know, do we? So what I'm going to do is I'm going to take out this little clip here. There's a little clip there, and you just push it out of the way. And take the rod off. And now see what happens when I pull the lever. Really, it doesn't move very much. So doesn't move very much, but it moves. Let's have another look, shall we? Okay, there's the lever. Yeah, I don't think it's pulling it far enough, so I'm hoping that there is some kind of adjustment. Let's just reset it one more time and attach the clip. Yeah, it would appear, and let me just check this here. Yeah, it's not being pulled far enough, so that it would appear that the problem is not here but here somewhere, so I need to find out why. Before I do that, I'm just going to put the clip back on because I don't want to lose it. And now I have to take off this panel here and see what I can see. Well, next thing is to get this panel off and let's see what we can see. Sorry, you're kind of probably looking up my nose right now. It could be worse, you could be looking up my ass. Believe me, that's probably not pleasant at all. Unless you're gay, I guess. Gay, poof, queer, whatever term you want to use. It doesn't really matter, does it? Huh? They're just terms. They're things. What the hell's this lot? There's more screws here. I'm beginning to wonder if somebody's already been here with this problem, because I'm finding all sorts of screws. Oh dear. Oh, they got the lacquer, a bit of a ripple there. These guys did a half good job. That's what I find strange. I really do. But hey, yeah, you know, this runs. Okay, it's inside the trunk, so it, or boot, so it doesn't matter, but I don't know. Maybe it was a Mako job. Okay, here we go. What have I got here? Okay. So this pulls down. I'm hoping there's something I can adjust. Sure as hell doesn't feel like it. So maybe it's just worn and I need to take it out and do some kind of adaption. I think that is what my choice is going to be. I'm going to have to take all this out of here and see. Maybe there's an adjustment. Maybe I could need to move it this way. I'm really clutching at straws there. I don't know. Not had this problem before. Look at this, you know, see, that's, that should have been cleaned off. As I said, they did a half decent job. All right, so I can, it's flat. Yeah, it's flat, that's what it is. Oh, and that's badly worn. I think what I'm going to have to do, and I don't know yet, maybe I'm going to have to take that rod off, weld it up, and then re-drill it, because there's a lot of play there, hell of a lot of play. Well, of course there would be after, you know, all these years. But it's not a 5 minute job to fix this. Yeah. Okay. And you see, still didn't pull it enough. Let's try again. Is it? Is it that this lock mechanism is worn out? It appears to be a screw there. I wonder if that's an adjustment. Okay, I'm going to rewind here, guys. I'm going to take this off and have a look inside and see if there's some kind of adjustment or like a worn component in here that I can mend before I start delving in around here. And to do that, there's four screws here. Now you're in the wrong place, aren't you? Oh, that didn't make you giddy. These four screws here. Oh, rewind. Take that clip off again. And just save it there. Pull the rod off. Mr. Stewart. Rod, Stewart. Come on, guys, pay attention. And this is all greasy. I'm sorry, but I just don't understand why they didn't clean these up. It just takes a few moments to clean it up. I mean, it's so greasy. It's, and they painted it. They must have taken it out to paint it. Am I being too critical? And I know I keep saying I don't like to criticize other mechanics or people, but sometimes things get really frustrating when you realize it. Okay, it takes a few minutes. Yeah, okay, you know, time is money and all of that shit, but come on. How long does it take to put this in a jar of cellulose thinners, shake it around, and pull it out? Because that's exactly what I'm going to do. Whether this is where the problem is or not, I will take this out and clean it. Oh wow, that I'm hoping, hey, come back, don't you dare try and escape. It may be that this boot lock is worn out. Oh boy, taking this thing apart is going to be fun. I wonder, is that the problem? Is it this lock that is the problem? Well, I gotta say that by pulling it, it works. Looks like somebody tried to lubricate it. So it could be that the rod is worn. Are you worn, Rod? I'm still going to take the rod out. All right, that's where we are. I'm going to clean this up and take the rod out. I'll be back. Okay, this is kind of experiment time. I think I mentioned before, I've not taken one of these apart. It also helps if you use the right screwdriver. So I want to get all this mechanism out and see why it's not working properly. Maybe it's just worn, needs welding up and re-drilling. We will see. Okay, these are the little plastic, not plastic, these are the little clips you need to get out of the way. Okay. Okay. Don't think I'm going to need to take this lock out. Oh yes I am, because it's dirty and I'm going to clean it. Ha! See, I lied again. You just can't trust me, can you? I lie. Lie, lie, lie! Lie! Alright, another one of those lovely little clips. And pull that out. And here she comes. Or maybe not. Oh yep, it does. Just needs a little piggery jokery. Okay, so let me see what the hell's going on here. Jeez, getting caught up with wires and all sorts. Well, there's no fucking adjustment on it, that's for sure. So why are you pulling one way and not the other? That is my question. The question that is mine. There's no play there. There's a bit of play in that. Isn't this a conundrum? And we have that nice spring washer in there. I wonder if those holes are yeah, that's quite worn, isn't it? Let's get this on the bench and have a look at it and see if I can figure out why, because that really should. Yeah, there's quite a bit of play in that, but then that would affect them both, not just that one, not just this side. And there is absolutely no adjustment. So you're really kind of limited there. Which makes me point back to the lock. Okay, let me put that there. I've got to take this lock out because, as I said, I want to give it a clean. I see no reason not to while I'm here. I'm sure the customer would rather get into the boot of his car than not. And I'm sure we would rather this looked a little cleaner too. I'm going to go crazy with it, but I'm just going to at least give it a clean up. And also, having them both out will give me the opportunity to check the function on both of them to see if maybe, for whatever reason, it's not working. And I know I said this earlier, I cannot understand why the person that painted this car didn't just soak these. I mean, looking at the paintwork here, it's obvious these have been out. Because, well, for one thing, they weren't masked up like they did on some of the other stuff. I'm sorry, I'm not happy when I'm knocking other people's work. So I figure then, you know, karma. All right. 2463, okay. All right, let me take this and give this a clean as well. And see if I can figure out what the fluck's going on. Right, these are the two locks from the Jaguar S-Type. They have been soaking for 2 days now inside cellulose thinners. And the reason I chose cellulose thinners is it really gets in there. So let me pour the excess into here. And let's dump these out onto the cloth. That's one side. Looking a darn sight cleaner, but still needs a little bit of attention with a little bit of a wire brush. Not going to be a problem. And let's get the second one out. Mm-hmm. Okay, ah, that's good. That got, ah, yes, that's good. Yeah, I got rid of a load of crap. All right, so now let me, first of all, decant this back into its carafe. Whoa! Got a little bit of spillage there, but that's okay. That's why I have this towel down on my bench to catch all the shit where I make mistakes. All right, let's get these jars back here and down here in my jar collection. Okay, good. And because I use cellulose, the cellulose thinners, it's evaporated pretty much already. Let me, where's my wire brush? Stay there and look at these two looks. I'm going to get the wire brush. Okay, I'm here, so let's give that a quick brush off, and that, looking pretty good. Turn it down, just in case, we'll give that a bit of a clean off there. I mean, these, I'm not restoring these, please don't think I'm restoring this, I'm not. I'm just cleaning this up because I want to try and make it work. Customer is not wanting to me to restore his car. He merely wants me to do some work on it. So that'll do there. I really would love to restore it, I must admit, but hey, you know, only do what the customer wants. He doesn't want it restored. Restoration costs more than making it work. And it appears we have a washer missing, so I'm going to have to find a washer. That's okay. All right, let's do this one now. As you can see, because I've done the cellulose, it doesn't take much to get this last bit of crap off. Now, I've got to hope that this lock is working okay. Yeah, really, I don't want to start taking this thing apart. But I do have a supplier who can give me S-type parts. And he is actually very familiar with S-types, which is always extremely handy. I know a fair bit about them, but I don't know everything. Which is why when you watch my videos and you hear me be a little hesitant, it's because I have great knowledge of Jaguars. But I don't have full knowledge, and I'm always willing to learn. Some people aren't. I am. Even though I'm an old fart, I am willing to learn. Okay, so that works quite nicely when it gets a good pull. How about this one? Same thing. So it appears that the both catches are working. Let's see, what are we looking at? 16th, 8th, 3/16 and click. Okay, this one. 16th, 8th, ooh, hang on. Let me do that again. About a 16th, about an 8th. And that seems to have a bit more movement on it, does it? No, I'm talking out my ass. No, that's about, they're both about the same. So I really don't think there's anything wrong with the locks themselves. What I'm going to try and do, that's loose. Are you going to allow me to, oh no, because it's pinned over there. What I am going to do is I'm going to pour some lubricant in through this crack on this one. I'll do the same on this one as well. You see, I've got just a little gap here, and this is holding it in place. This is holding this cover in place, and I don't really want to start taking that apart. Part number's 2463, by the way. Well, he's on that one. Haha, the other one's got to be different because they're sided. 740376. 740370. Ooh, is that an 8? No, it could be an 8 or a 6. Hard to tell. The casing's the same, but obviously the way the orientation of the lock itself is different. See that the higher the longer leg is at the top there, and the longer leg here is at the bottom. So that's the difference when you put them into the vehicle, because obviously they go in like that. All right, let me get another 1, 2, 3 spring washers, star washers, whatever you want to call them, so that I know I've got the correct set. Then I'm going to set this up and fill it full of some form of lubricant. I haven't decided what yet. I do have a very nice silicone one that is in a spray can, so I think I might squirt that in there. I could squirt other things, but we'll just do that. All right, I'll be back. Well, I've got this one open. It is very stiff, and I've cleaned it up now, so don't think it was dry. I am now going to pack this with copper grease. Why? Because I like it. No. Copper is a natural lubricant, believe it or not. Perhaps I should rub some on my dick. first you have to find somewhere to fuck. Who said that? Stop it. Oh, you are awful. God, who used to say that? Dick Emery. Oh, you are awful, but I like you. Ah, dear, the oldies are goodies. Right, so, yeah, I'm literally going to pack this full of copper grease. Do I need to pack it? No, probably not. But I want to try give it the best chance I can to actually function. And it's going to take me, I'm going to have to work it a bit and try and get the lubrication everywhere. Not necessarily easy, but hey, it's what I do. So, as you can see, I'm shoving it everywhere, as the actress said to the bishop. And was it the bishop said to the actress? Ooh, now there's a novel thought. Maybe it was reciprocal. There's a big word for a Sunday afternoon. A reciprocal. Oh, by the way, it's President's Day today. Well, for me, every president but the current one. Sorry, guys. That man is a buffoon. I'm not sure who was worse, him or Bush. Yes, I know. The only reason I think that he got in, and I could be wrong, is that people didn't like Trump because he kind of spoke the truth a lot of the time, and that he also did do some real dumb tweets. But they didn't look at what he'd achieved. The people that voted for Biden, I believe, didn't look at what Biden was, or what his policies were, or what he could achieve. They just said, I hate Trump, so I'm voting for the other guy. They hated Trump without realizing what that man had actually done for this country, which is a great shame. But that's the way it goes. We are now stuck with him for the next 4 years, if he lives that long. I know that anybody's going to assassinate him, because why waste a good bullet? Okay, yes, I'm biased. You know that. Each to their own. I'm sure my opinion is not echoed by all of my subscribers, But there you go. It's my opinion. It's my channel. I can say what the fuck I like. Right, so now, let's put this back on. That goes there and there. All right, and I'll... gonna have to pinch that down and peen it over. That seems to be quite good. Let's see if I can hold it together and do it, shall we? Okay, so she did up. I tell you what, guys, that feels so much better. And it feels so much better, I think I'm going to do the same on the other side. Because that is really smooth. Yep, especially after that's been worked a bit. Needs a bit of work, you've got to work it. That's okay. I'm going to get that copper grease everywhere. My hands keep slipping off. I mean, I'm hoping this catch isn't worn beyond redemption. And if it is, then we'll go through the same process and I will have to get hold of my supplier and see if he can provide me with a newer, less used, less worn catch. Don't really want to have to try and buy one of these. I really doubt it was ever remanufactured. Yep, so there you go. All right, so we have progressed. I am going to take this one apart now and slap it full of copper grease. I will clean it out like I did before with the other one, with the brake cleaner. Then slap it full of copper grease and then reinstall and keep my fingers crossed. I'll take you along for the ride once I'm in that place. look at my hand, it's white. It's brake cleaner. It washed all the grease off my hand. So I better go and get me some corn huskers and rub it in my skin, because otherwise that's going to fuck with me later. Okay. I have reinstalled the linkage. I've left these bolts loose here, so it gives me a little bit of play, and I've replaced that flat washer, which was totally wrong, with just a normal washer. Unfortunately, I couldn't find a perfect one, but I found something that's a darn sight better. Now what I need to do is grab these two locks, put those back in, and see how the mechanism works. Give me a second, let me get them back in and we'll go for it. Right, I have taken these locks apart, greased them thoroughly, realigned the bolts here, and now we're in the lock position. Let us see, this is the troublesome one, what happens when I pull the lever. Ooh, it's a little slow, but it releases. Ah, there you go. Look at that. Try the one this side. And you can hear it. A swift movement. Beautiful. Now, the acid test. Let's shut the boot. And I'm going to leave my tools inside because I'm feeling remarkably confident, which is stupid. It doesn't want to shut. Oh, yes, it does. Ooh, them stiff. But it opens. Yeah, you have to be careful with that. There we go. Okay, problem resolved. Push these wires back up, put that panel back on, put those covers back on, and we're done. Hopefully the customer will be pleased. I know he didn't ask me to do this, but I'm sure he wants to get in and out of the boot of this vehicle. Even though when he, put those boxes in there, it worked. It didn't want to work when it was here for whatever reason. And that whatever reason was the fact it really needed damn good lubrication. So that's it. I'm going to put those covers back on. Dunk, dunk, and that cover back on over there. And that's the end of this video. Again, always, always, guys, very appreciative of your attendance, watching my videos. Sorry. Like, comment, subscribe. Ding the dong. You'll get notified of more shit when I do it. Though, why you want to, I don't know. But I'm glad you do, and I do appreciate it. So, as always, now get out in that garage and do some shit.